Today we are discussing with one of the important chapter our CBSE board textbook real numbers. That is, what is mean by a real number? Real number means a connective of number system. That is, very beginning all of you know very well about the natural numbers. Natural numbers are the numbers which we generally use for the counting. That is, in the least number of the natural numbers is the 1 and the highest number is cannot define. That is, n is equal to set of 1, 2, 3 and so on. That is, in the set of natural numbers, the least number is the 1 and the highest number we cannot define. And the set of natural numbers are denoted with capital N. Next, set of whole numbers. How to define a whole number? Whole numbers are the numbers. To the natural numbers, you include 0, then the set of numbers formed is called a set of whole numbers. That means, in the set of whole numbers, the least number is 0 and the highest number is not defined. Next, what is meant by an integer? Next, set of integers. How set of integers will form? The set of the group of negative numbers and the positive numbers together 0 will form a set of integers. Integers are denoted by the letter I or J. That is, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. That means, the least number of the integers we cannot define, and at the same time the maximum number of the integers also we cannot define. Next, irrational number. How to define a rational number? Rational numbers are denoted with the letter Q. Very beginning, what is meant by rational numbers? Rational numbers are of the form P by Q. That means, a numbers are which are of the form, fraction form, there is a P by Q form, are called rational numbers. Here, P, Q are collected from the integers, that is Z, and Q not equal to 0. This is the definition of rational numbers. Now, we can discuss more about the rational numbers. That is, a number which are of the form P by Q are all rational numbers? Yes, the numbers which we can mention in the form of P by Q or we can call it as a rational numbers. Now, see, after this one, every rational number can be expressed as in two different forms. That is, either terminating or non-terminating repeating. Next, what are the mean by terminating decimal? Terminating decimal means which will get the remainder 0. Suppose, for example, 5 by 2. 5 by 2 is nothing but 2.5. Next, secondly, 10 by 3. 10 by 3 means approximately there is a 3.33333, so on, that which is called as 3.3 bar. That is, which is a terminating decimal, which is a non-terminating repeating decimal. That is, terminating non-terminating repeating, non-terminating repeating, these two are called rational numbers, denoted with Q. That means, every rational number can be expressed as either terminating or non-terminating repeating decimals. Then, one more, decimals are three in types. Number 1, terminating. Number 2, non-terminating. Number 3, non-terminating repeating. Among the three, two are selected as rational numbers. Then what about the third one, which is called as an irrational numbers? That is, irrational numbers are denoted with, next one, नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग रिपीटिंग होगा. नेक्स्ट नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग डेसिमल्स आर denoted with q dash, that is irrational numbers. Therefore, the union of, that is union of rationals and irrationals, we can call as a real numbers. That means, or in some people we also, they mention q dash also with s. Therefore, what we understand mean by real number? A real number is a combination of rational and irrational. Okay, from our previous knowledge we can decide that all natural numbers are whole numbers, that is natural numbers is subset to whole numbers, and all whole numbers are integers, that is whole numbers is subset to integers, and all integers are subset to the rational numbers. Now, in the number system, the least number system is the natural numbers, and the biggest in this group is the rational. Now, q dash is separate from this. That means q and q dash are quite different to each other. Now, that is, if you combine these two, that is rational numbers union irrational numbers will gives you a real number. Okay, our next topic is Euclid's division lemma or Euclid's division algorithm. We know the meaning of algorithm. Algorithm means a step by step procedure to solve the problem. And then lemma. Lemma means which is a connective to a theorem or a part of a theorem. Now, let a comma b are positive integers. Let a comma b are the two positive integers. Then there exist. Then there exist unique q comma r. Then there exist unique nothing but one and only one. Then there exist unique, here it is a very important word, unique, one and only one, unique q comma r such that A is equal to BQ plus R. This is the condition where 0 less than or equal to R less than B. What are the positions of A, B, Q and R? That is, A is dividend. Now, B is your divisor. And q be the quotient and r be the remainder. Okay, now what are the positions of a, b, q, r? Are you very clear here? Once again I do repeat, let a comma b are any two positive integers, then there exists a unique q comma r such that means here we can observe four different variables, that is a, b, q, r. They can arrange in the form of a is equal to bq plus r, and one of the very most important condition they must satisfy, this one, that is your remainder is either 0 or greater than 0, and your remainder must be always less than b. Who is a b here? B is a divisor. Next, a is a dividend, b is a divisor, q is the quotient and r be the remainder. Okay, now how to find the HCF of the given two numbers or three numbers by using the EDL, that is Euclid's division lemma. Now let us consider the two numbers. The first example, LCM of 24 and 38. First of all, follow the division method. 1 time 24, 8 minus 4, 4, 14, 24, 1 time 14, 10, 1 time 10, 4, 10, 2 times 8, 2, 4, 2 twos. We have to continue the process till you get the remainder 0. Therefore, your HCF is 2. It is a division method. With the help of this one, now how to do? Let us see. You know, A is equal to BQ plus R. Now let us identify the position. This is the A, B, quotient, this is the remainder. Follow these steps continuously. That is, first your A is 38 is equal to, quotient is 1 time. Your quotient, sorry, B is divisor, that is a 24 times quotient is a 1 plus the remainder is 14. That is in the second step. In the second step, 24 is your new dividend. That is 24 is equal to 14 into 1 plus remainder is 10. In the next step, what is your new dividend? 14 is your new dividend. 14 is a breakdown into 10 into 1 plus remainder is 4. 10 ones are 10 plus 4, 14. Next, what is your new dividend in the next step is a 10. 10 will be write as 4 times 2 plus remainder is 2. 4 twos are 8. 8 plus 2, 10. Next dividend is 4. Then divisor 2 into quotient is a 2 plus remainder is 0. That is, you have to continue this process until you will get the remainder 0. Therefore, this part is called now HCF, highest common factor. Therefore, conclude the answer. Therefore, HCF of 24, 38 is 2. Let us follow the next example. Second example, 45 and 26. From these two, 26 is the least. 45, that is 1 time 26. That is 5 minus 6 is not possible. Come on, borrowed, get borrowed. 15 minus 6, that is 9. 1 is borrowed, 3 left, 3 minus 2, 1, 26, again 1, 19, 7, 19, 7 threes are 21, therefore 7 twos are 14, the remainder is 5. 1 time 5, 7 minus 5, 2, 5, that is 2 twos, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2 is 2. Now the remainder is 0. Continue the process till you will get the remainder 0. Therefore, HCF is 1. Now, based on this one, now you can prepare the data. Come on, first. 45 is your dividend. First, dividend, divisor, quotient, remainder. That is 45 can be break down into 26 into 1 plus remainder is 19. That is A is equal to BQ plus R. That is next. What is your next dividend? 26. 26 is a breakdown into 19 into 1 plus remainder is 7. Next, 19 breakdown into 7 2s are 14 plus remainder is 5. Next, 7 breakdown into 5 1s are plus 2. Next, 5 breakdown into 2 times 2 plus 1. Next, 2 break down into 1 times 2 plus 1 times 2 plus remainder is 0. Therefore, this part is called HCF. Therefore, conclude the answer. HCF of what are the two numbers? 26 and 45 is 1. Next, the rest of the two numbers you can solve in the same way. Next model is, find the HCF of three numbers are given here. Find the HCF of the three numbers by Euclid's division lemma. Now, first of all, find out the HCF of any two numbers. By using these two numbers, you will get the HCF. With that number, you can go through the third one. Now, let us see. First, we will go through by the division method. Now, from these, collect the first two numbers. That is, from these two, the least number is 1794, 2346. It is a 1700 around, this is 2300 around. That is one time 1794. 6 minus 4, 2. 14 minus 9, 5. Here 1 borrowed, that is a 12 left, 2 left, that is a 12. 12 minus 7, 5. Next, from here 1 borrowed, 1 left, 1 minus 1, 0. 552, 1794. Go for the estimation method. It is 500 something around, this is 1700 something. That is, let us check with 3 times. 5523. How we know 5 times means 5 threes are 15. That is around 1500 range. Suppose if you place here 4, 5 4s are 20, that is a 2000 range. But here only 1700 is there. Okay, that is why 6, 15, that is 16, 1656, 1656. How many times? That is a 3 times. Next, 14 minus 6, that is 8. Here 1 borrowed, 8 left. 8 minus 5, that is a 3. 7 minus 6, that is a 1. Now, shift 552 here. Again, this is 130 around. This is 550 around. That is, now I will 138.4, I will see 138.4. That is 32, 12 plus 3, 15, 4 ones, 4 plus 1, that is a 5, 552. Okay, 552. That is the remainder is 0. That is how many times? 4 times. Therefore, your HCF is 138. Is, which is HCF. Now I have to, by Euclid's division lemma method, but this is the division method. After this one, you know how to frame the next steps. Come on. Your first dividend, 2, 3, 4, 6 can be break down into 1794 into 1 plus the remainder is 552. Next, your new dividend is 1794, which will be break down into 552 into 3 plus remainder is 138. Next, 552 can be break down into 138 into 4 plus 0. Therefore, 138 is HCF of, HCF of, what are the two numbers? 1794 and 2346 is 138. Now, take this 138 and the next number is 4761. That is, see, it is in hundreds, it is in thousands. There is a lot of gap between the two numbers. Now let us check. Suppose 10 times 1300 will come. 2 times, that is 2600. 3 times 13 threes are 39, that is which is the nearest. 4 times means there is a 4200. That is, let us check with 138 into 35, take first. 35 times I will. 5 8s are 40. 5 3s are 15 plus 4, 19. 5 1s 5 plus 1, 6 into 3 8s are 24. 3 3s are 9 plus 2, 11. 3 1s 3, 4, that is 0. 9 plus 4, 13. 6 7 8. 8, that is a 4830, but here only 4700 is there. I taken 34 times. Now just you can subtract 1, that is 138 fours you can collect here. 138 34s, that is 8 fours are 32, 12 plus 3 15, 4 ones 4 plus 1 5 into 3 eights are 24, 3 threes are 9 plus 2 11, 3 ones 3 plus 1 4, that is 2 9 6 4, that is a 4 6 9 2. Okay, we can 34 times 4 6 9 2. Now 1 minus 2 is not possible. 11 minus 2 9, 1 borrowed here 5, there is a 15. 15 minus 9 6, 1 borrowed here 6 minus 6 0, 69 138. Now that is 1 time. 2 times means 140. 2 times 69 twos, 9 twos 18. Yes, 138 is sufficient. Therefore, 69 is the LCM of, sorry, 69 is the HCF of the given two numbers. Therefore, arrange this one. 4761 is equal to 138 into 34 plus 69. Next, 138 is equal to 69 into 2 plus 0. That is, therefore, that is HCF of 1794 2346 4761 is 69.